जिन्हें जो हार चुके हैं, हम उनका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं, हार्दिक स्वागत करते हैं।
Kerana is always a hot seat in Uttar Pradesh, and behind me is a 27-year-old young girl, Ikra Hassan, who's fighting her first election. And this is from Kerana. She's a SP Congress candidate from Kerana. She's an SOAS graduate from London in 2020. Before that, she studied in LSR in Delhi. And 2020, from London, she landed back in Kerana and has been seen in the last assembly elections campaigning for her brother Nahid Hassan, who is presently the MLA from Kerana. She comes from an illustrious political family, Munawwar Hassan. The late Munawwar Hassan is her father. Her mother, Tabassum Hassan, has also been an MP from this seat. And Nahid Hassan is the two-time MLA from this seat. And he is the brother of Ikra Hassan. This time, Ikra Hassan is playing the emotional card in Kerana. She is going to elders, taking their Ashirwad and asking for their votes for a win here against the BJP candidate who is a sitting MP. Can Ikra Hassan do her magic? After studying international law and politics from SOAS London, she's in the hard politics here in Kerana, in the dust and the mud, and trying to tell people that vote for me because I come from a family which will bring you justice and which will bring you development in Kerana. We are joined by 27-year-old Ikra Hassan, who's fighting her maiden election from Kerana, and she's graduated from London in 2020, and now she's in the heat and dust of Kerana fighting a maiden election. So Ikra ji, how has been this journey from London to Kerana and fighting an election? Did you ever think you will do this?
Very unexpected. I had other plans. I had plans to do my PhD. I did my master's, and I got myself enrolled into PhD, but because of Corona, I came back home for a bit, and since then I'm just here. Then the situation at home, my mother and my brother were implicated in false cases. So my brother, who's now the MLA of Kerana, his election was right around the corner. So I had to stay back home and help with that since he was in jail. So that's how it began. And since then, it took 1 year for us to get him out of the prison. So for that 1 year, I had to take care of all his work, MLA work, and so I was doing that, and then my interest grew and I had formed connections with people, so I liked doing it eventually, and then now I'm trying to contest the election and hopefully win.
Ikra ji, that actually when you came back from London, as you said, it was a tough time for your family. Your brother Nahid Hassan, who's currently the MLA from Kerana, was that time in jail. So that was a phenomenal victory in 2022. Your brother is in jail, you campaign for him, and he wins the election.
Yeah, it was by God's grace we managed to win. I was new here. I didn't know the workings of politics locally, but the people really helped. They took us hands-on and helped me with how the management should be, how we should do the campaign. So it was not just me. I was just the face of it, but it was the people of Kerana who actually helped put us where we are.
And Ikra ji comes from a very politically illustrious family. Her father, the late Munawwar Hassan ji, was the MP from this seat. Her mother, Tabassum ji, has also been the MP from this seat. So it's a big responsibility also to shoulder when you have such an illustrious political family.
It is. I have a lot of privilege. I got this platform because of that privilege, but I don't take that privilege for granted any day, and I work through dust and sweat and everything every day. My working is the same as the election campaign, just the number of cars are lesser when we are in our normal day-to-day routine, but the routine is usually we do 10-12 villages every day. So I'm working hard, and I hope people will see that and will vote for me.
Coming to your political campaign this time, what is your main pitch to the voters here? What are you asking them that they should, why should they vote for you?
My personal request is that we should vote for change. If we do not, if we let the politicians think that they cannot be changed and that they have certain strings that they can pull and they'll always be elected, so they will never work for us. So we are hoping that people, since it's been 10 years, we've seen the double engine government, and our area, our constituency has not gotten anything that it should have gotten, some institutions maybe, because ours is a newer district. it was part of Muzaffarnagar. Now it's a new district, smaller district. So all of the government institutions are in Muzaffarnagar. Our zilla is vacant. So we were hoping, so that's what we are trying to tell people, that the government didn't do anything for us, and there's a lot of developmental work on the village level that has not been done. Plus this is a ganna belt, so the payment is an issue. We have to do dharnas every day, so that's an issue. There is a lack of educational facilities, higher educational facilities for women, healthcare facilities for women. So these are primarily the agenda.
Sugarcane issue also here. I was speaking to some farmer. The Shamli sugar mill has not paid the dues for almost a year. Do you think that is also that you are promising people that will change?
That is a major issue here. There was a dharna for 3 months that was happening in Shamli, and we still haven't gotten the payment back. So that's a major issue, and the government has not given any commitment on resolving the issue. So because this is the sugarcane belt, and most of the farmers here, they source sugarcane, so this is a never-ending issue until there is a solution for them by the
government. Last question, Ikraji. Kerala has always been said, you know, this Palayan issue was very big. BJP always made it a big issue in the elections. In a way, the polarization also was very much seen in Kerala. Do you think that has changed, and what is your answer to that? That was there Palayan or not?
There was never a Palayan. What had happened was a few of the families had shifted to bigger cities as their businesses grew. So that's a natural process. It happens everywhere, not just in Kerala. And there were a few families. And the BJP made it out to be a huge issue and tried to garner votes on the basis of it. So it was a propaganda issue. The people of Kerala had rejected it in 2017 by voting against BJP. In 2022, again, they voted against BJP in Kerala. And now the media, local media, has also stopped asking it because it's a non-issue. It was a propaganda and it has died.
The Muslim, Hindu-Muslim issue in the last election, that we know when it happens. This is a seat with nearly 18 lakh voters, you know, and there are about over 6 lakh Muslim voters. So obviously there is this issue that who votes for whom. Do you think you are appealing to all sections of society?
This is the first time. Right now we were in a Rajput village. Yesterday I was in a Saini village. So this is the first time that Hindu-Muslim is not an issue here. All the communities are coming together, and that's a positive change for the country.
Thank you so much. Thank you.